Radio. I think the radio element is interesting. So when I think of radio, I think of an outdated thing with like too many advertisements. I never listen to the radio personally. It's in cars, but a lot of people, you know, can hook up their aux cord. Tell me why radio? Am I wrong? Am I off base in thinking that it's kind of going by the wayside?
You know, it's interesting because, like, you know, there's this old term, isn't there? Video killed the radio star, because back in like the 1950s and 60s, everyone was like, TV's going to kill radio. And it survived, you know. I think it's like a personal medium. It's you and the presenter. So yeah, of course, not everyone listens to a radio now, but the audience data, it was really interesting. Like, so last year during this pandemic, was a great year for us as a business. We had a record number of new people starting up stations, and it varied from stuff that was like really like hyper local, so maybe like to service a specific community like a village or a smaller town or whatever, or it was to maybe focus on like providing entertainment, like, you know, specific genres of music or whatever it might be. And we also saw listener data, so because obviously we can see what our client stations, we can see how many people are listening. And we had about three times the amount of people listening across the board than we would normally see. And this sort of happened like overnight when it kind of got to like March, April time, when like lots and lots of different countries all over the world were sort of going into lockdown. And I think the reason for this is because people like that human interaction. You know, you can listen to a playlist on Spotify or Apple Music or whatever, and it's like generated by an algorithm. But it's just not the same of having that kind of human connection of you and the person playing the music on the other end and talking about it, telling you their stories, telling you about the information on what's going on in the local area or funny entertainment news, etc. So I think that's why radio is popular as it ever has been. And I think people turned to radio during lockdown because they were quite, you know, sometimes people sat on their own, and it's different to watching TV. I think it's like, it's you can have it on the background while you're doing other stuff. And this is kind of like why I really like podcasts as well, is because they're sort of like a, you know, a medium that you can digest them passively whilst you're doing other stuff. You don't necessarily have to be staring at a screen in order to gain from it.
The car, that's where most people listen to the radio
That's right, yeah.
because it's right there. Cars come wired with it.
That's the
And
thing. And I think, you know, we're an online radio provider. So
online.
yeah. So basically, you know, our system links in with pretty much any device. So you can listen through smart speakers, you can listen to, you know, your iPhone, tablets, you know, obviously traditional desktop, laptops and stuff. And of course, you know, sometimes then the stations will then take it and take that feed and broadcast it over like a physical transmitter as well. And some are just online only. But I think, you know, again, the availability of things like smart speakers and the fact that, you know, you can basically, you know, you can connect your phone via Bluetooth to your car. You can play any radio station you want. So it doesn't have to just be what you're limited to on your sort of traditional dial. It can be, you know, if you're really into some random genre of music. Like, for example, some of our best successful stations, most successful stations are actually ones which play like really obscure stuff. So there's a genre of music called K-pop, which is
K-pop,
like,
it's South Korea, right?
Korean pop. And we have one particular client, they just play K-pop, and they get an obscene audience. It's like, it's so many, it's crazy how much of a following this thing has.
Really? That's awesome.